Good morning. I am V. Giriraj. I have been handling NREGA for the last 4 years in the state of Maharashtra. So I thought I would share my experiences. There is no economics in this and no figures. Basically, my experience as a practitioner on a day-to-day basis. There is a high subjective element in this. Bear with me. Next. Can you just... Okay. Now I have structured the presentation this way. The transition issues from 2006 to 2010, and the initiatives we have taken in the last 4 years to strengthen NREGA in the state, and the challenges and concerns we are facing. The one and two I'll rush through to give adequate time to number three. Now, as Mr. Dev said, we had the EGS in the state. It is actually the EG Act is called the EGA, Employment Guarantee Act 77, and the scheme is the EGS. We are still retaining the state act. We are not implementing MG NREGA, but there is an enabling section 27 or 28 in the act. So we are retaining the state act and we are implementing the central scheme. We are also having a state scheme. It's much less now. Now, the key point in this, there was no role for the Gram Panchayat at all in the old scheme. It was the commissioner, divisional commissioner, is a person who handles 5-6 districts, the collector and the tehsildar. So the works were very big, the line departments were handling, and lot of assets were created, as Mr. Dev told, particularly in the pre-90 period. And 60-40 ratio. Even if you go to the remote village in Maharashtra, they know what is Sat Chalis. So that was work-wise. Machines were allowed for skilled portion. I don't know when it was allowed, maybe from 90s. The contractors were allowed for skilled portion because the engineering department said we can't do it departmentally. No more in the 50s and 60s it is possible, now no. This concept of shelf of works and the annual plan, which is in NREGA in a different way, originated from this state act. We used to call it blueprint. And very interestingly, we had an individual benefit scheme because the EGS was funded through the professional tax. And the policy makers at that point of time in the late 70s said if there is more money, then that could be absorbed by the scheme, then what do we do? Then they said we have to improve the farm lands. So they introduced that there is an enabling provision, section 710 of the State Act, where we have an individual benefit, but it is on subsidy basis, on reimbursement basis, and it's still in place for horticulture and wells. You will be, and there is no weekly masters. It's a reimbursement basis, it's basically a subsidy program. And right now, we have both these schemes in horticulture, that is NREGA, horticulture under NREGA, and we also have under this. The well scheme we are winding up under the old state scheme. So you can imagine the confusion. Now the period 6 to 11, one big question people were asking, Maharashtra is the originator of this employment guarantee scheme, but why it didn't pick up? There are a lot of discussions and studies. Now, what we found was, there was total mix-up in the field between the old and new scheme. You may recall that the old scheme also was not introduced on one day. It came in three phases, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. So imagine, say, a place like Nashik Division, where in Dhule and Nandurbar you had NREGA, and in the neighboring district you had the old, like in Nashik or in Jalgaon. So, and the controlling office, the divisional commissioner office, has to give two set of guidelines to the field officials. And the mental block was more among the seniors because 30 years they were doing in a particular way. Now you have to work through the Jilla Parishad. So the conservator of forest will say, no, no, I did it like this. So the subordinate couldn't open their mouth before a very senior functionary. And the organizational structure was totally aligned to the old pattern. The resistance to accept the wider role for the Panchayat Raj institutions, 60-40 in NREGA, as you are aware, it is GP. or the taluka base, not item activity wise, work wise. And they said, no contractors, who will do the skill portions? And very interestingly, the region which really needed Narega, or even now needs Narega, the tribal part, the bordering the Satpuras and the Vindhyas or in the Gadchiroli, there they are not the politically articulate sections in room. And all dependent on the collector, adequate support was not being given from the secretariat side in terms of specific guidelines. So, some collector was enthusiastic, he did good work. Then somebody came, performance came down. Now we have initiated a lot of strategic changes, still they are going on. First is of course removing the confusion. We found that, you know, it took a year. Unlearning is more difficult than learning. And three steps. Then one important step was decentralization. The technical and administrative sanction were delegated to the block level, that is the program officer. The Gram Rozgar Sahayaks or Sevaks, as we call them in Maharashtra, we have appointed in each Gram Panchayat. That is, there are 28,000 Gram Panchayats in Maharashtra. We gave them, I mean, there was role clarity, and then we are paying them as per performance. In many states, they are given a fixed amount. We pay them as per mandates. And then we have appointed more than 2,000 contract staff. I have just given the list of people. Now this is very important. You know, in private sector, they go on changing the organizational design as per the requirements. But it's not so easy in a government framework. It took a lot of effort. This was the earlier design, and without, you know, creating posts, etc., a very big challenge in government. We did some tweaking, and I have slowly shifted it towards the Panchayat Raj institutions. Even within the divisional commissioner office, we have put people with the background of having worked in Panchayat Raj from their cadre. And I am happy to say that Gram Panchayats are contributing 75% as is the intention in the total expenditure and works. So this is a tectonic shift has happened. We created a state society for funds management as per Government of India's guidelines. And IT, I think MIS has been extremely useful for us. E-masters, EFMS, a proper website, uploading all policy guidelines. And about 40-50 guidelines have been issued for each type of work. Earlier it was not there, and each district was allowed to work on its own way. These are the steps we have taken for empowerment of wage seekers in Gram Panchayats, helpline, payslips for workers, social audit. They are all work in progress, and we want to strengthen these initiatives in this year. Year means 2014-15. We have placed state quality monitors, and these are retired people with technical background, and they go and inspect the works. The feedback has been quite helpful, and something like they have given 60 to 65% as satisfactory about the quality of works. 30% they say need some improvement, only 15% they have written as bad. So about 500-600 works have been checked on a random basis. These are the range of control mechanisms we have put. We have one something very unique in Maharashtra, which everybody fears, that is the EGS Legislative Committee. There is about 20 members of the legislative, they visit district to district. This is a legacy of the old EGS, because in those days these other controls were not in place. So they thoroughly check and ask questions, and in fact the fear of this committee itself prevents some of the field officials to take Narega works. Only if you do, then you will be asked. And as a result of all these initiatives, our person days and expenditure has increased by about 4 times in the last 3 years. And which was this Pune and Konkan division, phase 3 districts of course, which were almost zero in the 9-10. Now it has increased manifold. And there are some works, at least some expenditure has been incurred, 18,000 to 20,000 gram panchayats out of 20. We have a long way to go. And at least one thing I am very happy that a system aligned to NREGA requirements is in place. In Maharashtra, we have drought once in 3 years, almost certain, if not in the whole state, in many parts of the state. We are totally dependent on the monsoon. And suddenly at that time, people wake up, you know, we should give work to people. But you have to keep your machine oiled. You cannot do it on one day. So this somehow is lost sight of, you know, by the political class. So we have been trying to at least keep this machine well oiled so that any contingency we can quickly, you know, expand our work. Now I want to share with you the, I hope I want time, challenges and concerns while working. The first thing is to bring in one change, you have to bring in lot of preparatory, to take a lot of preparatory steps. For example, now we have started compensation for delay in wages from January. I mean, operationalized from March, but we are paying from January. It took 1 year to do the groundwork. The e-masters, the EFMS, continuous layers in the banks and post offices. And none of them are under our control. One work, two measurement books, additional contract engineers. Now to recruit 300, 400 people, so many issues come. So this I wanted to share. One of the way to do it is to allow the contract staff to do the measurement. But the BDO, I mean the program officer, wavers. He says, how can I depend on this contract staff? He comes tomorrow, he leaves. He gets some other job, he leaves. So this type of very local issues come, and we have to face these issues day to day. I have given another example. Very simple, it may look very thin. You appoint auditors. We found when in 2010, one district was paying 20,000, another district was paying 3 lakhs. I said, how is it possible? What we found was the one firm was checking each voucher, another firm was only putting the balance sheet, just consolidation of accounts. Their scope of work was not defined. So how do you choose? Do you pay them on a tender basis? Obviously, you cannot hire doctors and lawyers or audit firms on a tender basis. And government is extremely weak, especially the field machinery, when they want to purchase services. Buying materials, 50-year, 100-year experience in tendering. But how do you purchase services at the district level, the type of staff who require? So preparing a TOR, we hired a consultant to guide us, a financial expert. A lot of steps have to be taken to do one small thing. And now it is a reasonable good system is in place. Now the third is, NREGA is a very unique work. This was so in EGS. Maximum complaints used to come. Why does it come? One step leads to another. And if somewhere one chain weakens, then the whole work gets affected. And ultimately, the labor doesn't get payment on time. Let's show you. Now, here and there, you know, this MIS entry is now proceeding. There are small changes, but you'll get a flavor of what all steps are involved to, you know, ultimately the laborer gets payment. I put it in a different way here. Anything collapses anywhere, we have problems. And we are assuming everything is there. And none is under our control. Nothing. You are assuming the collector is under me? No. You are assuming that the joint is under me? No. Banks? No. None of them, the Gram Rozgar Sevak are appointed by the village community. So it's a big challenge, and every day, you know, at the end of the day, oh, it has happened. Now, this is also a little hierarchical structure we have devised. Now, all other programs are, you know, pension programs are all single department. Here, it is almost like, you know, I humorously say this Narega is like Dadar railway station, you know, who comes, what, I mean, it's happening, but it's, you know, that simile people understand more easily. So this is the hierarchy we have. Now the big question for us is, what is the organizational structure? Now this is a managerial issue. There are no answers. One is full-time regular staff at the cutting edges, not there. If we create, they say, do you need so many people? And it is a seasonal work. The average in Maharashtra PD per year is 45 to 50. Then issues of distances, varied players when no one is boss of another and have often conflicting priorities and also non-hierarchical. The right fit organizational design yet to emerge and hardly any guidance. There are hardly any studies that you should do like this. So you feel very lonely sometimes. What should be this? For any decision, there is another opinion. The staffing, we assume the contract staff, fresh from college, knows what to do from on day number one. It takes 1 year. By that time, if he's too smart, he obviously will not continue here. Again, there is a lot of cadreization. The agriculture graduate will say, I will not do civil engineering. A lot of local issues. Even the collectors and COs take time to understand the Narega's terminology. Maybe we need to put some small video training course for them, like labor budget. These are all new. It is not they can't adjust in day number one, because only when they take up, they understand these issues. And in a state like Maharashtra, which is the second biggest in India, situation varies from location to location. And we ourselves do not know who is underutilized and who is stretched. Almost one continuous changes are there, about one-third changes every year. And you know, some sort of a caste system comes here also. The contract staff says, no, we are not respected in the panchayat samitis, we are not treated properly. Now this is the well-known three priorities of Narega. There are certain inherent conflict situations. This I draw from Jairam Ramesh, who used these 3 points. For example, some places they want roads, which is not a priority. In Narega, for example, some of these sarpanchas, the gram panchas, tell us we want roads, whereas ideally watershed is the work they require. Another issue is right understanding of a concept go down the channel up to GP level. Because by the time it goes from here to the district, to the block, down, there is a lot of distortion or misunderstanding. We don't know how to reach to the last village. Frequent changes. And see what happens. Barrage of instructions comes. By the time it percolates, it becomes redundant. You know, I have read in old days, you know, this treaty agreements used to be made between two warring countries, but the foot soldiers will be fighting somewhere in the field because they never got the news that, you know, 500 kilometers, it's happened in American War of Independence or somewhere. So how to be quickly and effectively communicate to vast numbers? We ourselves do not know the other side, the feedback. I am telling top down from bottom. Much of feedback is impressionistic. They will tell their experience, but in Narega, there are many angles to an issue. We also don't know whether it is systemic or local. You have a review meeting, it will be highly local. So this we have to segregate. And very sadly, the feedback from way journals is the weakest, because we meet the lot of officials and we would really like to know what are their concerns. Then there are certain internal issues which come in various fora where non-officials are present. Current wage rates are not attractive. Who will come in a state like Maharashtra? Maharashtra disturbs, I mean, Narega, availability of labor. But that is not factual, just for an information. The maximum attendance in end of May, peak summer, is about 5 lakhs. Our rural population is 5 lakh crores. This everybody says, this new generation are all educated. They don't want to do hard manual work. And since there are so many players, each can shift the blame on the other. Now this one question I ask myself, who owns NREGA for implementation? I mean, we have to push them so that to bring in more change. Gram Sevak, Gram Rozgar Sevak, Sarpanch and village community, that is the ideal situation. Contract staff, who has a stake? Wage laborers, sensitive government machinery. We want this not for any academic this one, but so that which will help us in our performance. So I, as a as an officer who has been implementing things, I need support in three areas, which is normally not talked about. It's assuming that it's your problem, you solve it. Right organizational design. Obviously, there cannot be a single fit, but we have to work on it. Much more studies are required. What are the HR issues peculiar to government in implementing such a massive program, and communication issues? Thank you.